The driver's side locking hub goes on easy and smooth. Passenger side locking hub goes on easy and smooth. All right. Here's the four-wheel drive high. It comes down easy. All right. You can see the light turns on. So let's test the four-wheel drive high. See how that works. All right. We're moving along with four-wheel drive high. Having a beautiful time in the woods. All right, so we're continuing with the four-wheel drive high. Driving around
my darling, sleep
like a freaking bastard. Okay, all right, now I'm gonna try the four-wheel drive low. See how this works? All right, four-wheel drive low is on. Let's try that. Now we got it going. It's got a lot of torque. That's first gear, second gear. So it works. We know that a four-wheel drive works. Let's make sure it disengages at a four low as well. That's my Jeep and the trailer that I'm working on. Okay, let's see the AC. All right, let me try the heater here. Seems to be a little bit of surface rust there under the passenger side area, but doesn't look bad at all. Move it, it's not really, doesn't even come close to rusting through. Jetta likes it. Driver's side has that kind of crumbly rust, but there's no rust through. Nothing, it looks like nothing that can be really, that couldn't be taken care of. This is under the driver's side rear seat area, and as a matter of fact, this is all dirt, like freaking 30 years of dirt. All right, this is the back panel, which I'm gonna open here. All right, it needs the shock on the left here, because it's that's busted. And then this needs little screws there. It doesn't seem to be anything bad. If you look inside, it doesn't seem to be any, there's no rust or anything in there. Just lower the gate. They're all like that, they all work. Radio, I don't figure that's the original. It's a cassette deck, which means it needs a CD player, that's for damn sure. Center console, emergency brake works great.